my channel, Apples and Tiaras. So today I have a really, really special video for you. So today I'm gonna be talking about my back to school hacks, or I guess just how I prepare for the school year and the most important things to me in order to be prepared for the school year. So the very first thing that I wanna talk about is number one. So I have 10 hacks here and I actually wrote them down in my notebook so that I don't forget. Also, I'm not wearing my glasses again, so if I'm squinting, I apologize. So the very first thing that I find is really important and is helpful for back to school is to have an organized closet. Being pregnant, it's a little bit different because I only fit in certain things and I have maternity clothes versus regular clothes. So what I've done is I've organized my closet to match my lifestyle. So I have it organized by work clothes, non-work clothes, but right now it's basically organized by maternity and what I can actually wear and then everything else. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip to that clip now. So this is an overview of my closet. It does go up pretty high, but as you can see, it's I mean, you can't tell, but it's organized by, these are all of my work clothes. So right now these are mostly all my maternity clothes, just basically everything that will fit me from now until the baby is here. And most of them are clothes that I would wear to work anyways, because a lot of my work clothes are like loose, baggy dresses, and like graphic t-shirts. So I organize everything in the closet by use, I guess. This is all of my husband's clothes. These are all of my like normal, like most of these I would wear to work if I wasn't pregnant, but these are all the clothes that I will be wearing now that I am pregnant. So I have them organized by like pants, skirts, tanks, and like short sleeve. And then I have short sleeve t-shirts. And then I've got all my graphic tees here. These shirts should fit me throughout the rest of the pregnancy. Maybe not towards the very end, but towards the beginning of the school year, they should fit. And then I have long sleeve shirts. And then I have a couple of kimonos that I like to wear like over either a tank or like a graphic tee to kind of like dress it up. And then I've got a couple of long maxi dresses here. And then it goes into like my t-shirt dresses and goes back by length. So these are like short sleeve dresses, longer sleeve, t-shirt sleeve, and then these are all longer sleeve dresses that aren't necessarily for maternity, but they will fit me throughout the rest of the pregnancy. So I have those, and then down here, I have like heels and stuff that I don't really wear to work. And then on this side, I have my pants that, these are all the like bottoms that have fit me throughout pregnancy and that should fit me through pregnancy. And then these are all like the shoes that I would wear to work. Down here, and then underneath, you can't really see, but these are all my bottoms that I would normally wear if I wasn't pregnant. These are leggings, so I'll probably wear those. Those are some like Chico pants from Old Navy, things like that. But my main reach section is going to be this side and this side, and then these are just like sweaters. Like I have my school sweater and, you know, whatever.
Going along with the organized closet, my second hack, or what I do to get ready for the school year, is I go shopping. And I don't spend a lot of money on clothes only because I like to get staple items that I can use all the time. So I'm gonna share with you a couple of staple items that I really like to have in my closet for teaching. And the first thing that I want to share is these Chico pants from Old Navy. Now, I love Old Navy pants and I love them for teaching because they're really stretchy, they're super comfortable, and they look very professional. So I'm just gonna show you a couple of options. They have tons of different colors, styles, but I do have a bunch of these in non-maternity, obviously, because I'm not pregnant all my life, but they look like this, and these are just some black and white polka dot ones, but they have the nice little pocket flap on the back. I don't know if you guys can see that because of the detailing, but they're basically ankle length, and then sometimes I roll mine up to be like more of a capri, or if I want them to be long, I leave them long, but they're a very skinny, tight-fitting pant, And I really like these because when you can't wear leggings, but you don't wanna wear like a pant with like a bell bottom or a flare at the bottom, if you like the skinny jean look, you will love these pants because they look skinny on. I also have a pair of maternity pants, and these are called, I think they're called Pixie or Chico in the store. So, and they're usually right in the front, but I did find a pair of these in the maternity section, and they just have the little panel here, which I love because I don't like the over the belly thing. It makes me itchy and I just don't like it. And I guess I can wear these after the baby's here because, you know, I'm gonna have a little pooch, but same thing, they're just maternity version. The next staple item that I'm going to talk about is a pair of shoes. Now, the brand that I have is probably not the brand that you will wanna get, it might be, but I invested in a pair of these Teeks. And the reason that I invested in them is because I've read tons of reviews from teachers that they absolutely love these Teeks, that they're super comfortable, that they last forever. Yes, they're expensive. I'm not gonna tell you how much I spent on these. I'm gonna let you go to the website and go ahead and research that yourself. But I did save for them so I can validate why I got them. But anyway, I love how they fold up. So if for some reason I wanted to wear a different pair of shoes for one day and bring these with me, that's fine. They're super easy to slip on, so that's easy for pregnancy. And you can get them in all kinds of colors. I personally like to have two pairs of flats in my wardrobe. This is my only pair of Teeks, and it is my only pair of black flats. I also have a pair of brown flats from Target. You can get black flats from Target. Honestly, you can get black flats anywhere, but I like to have two pairs of flats in my wardrobe, one black, one brown, to just go with every outfit imaginable. Okay, so moving on to my third back to school hack. So this kind of goes along with my teacher bag, and my teacher bag is actually number 5. So let's go to number 4 real quick. Number 4 is have a plan. And what I mean by that is have a plan for your classroom. Before the school year even ended last year, I got a piece of graph paper out and I started drawing what I wanted to do with my classroom. I had everything completely set up and ready to go so that when I walked in the door a couple of weeks ago, I knew where everything was going to go. So that's number 4, is just have a plan for your classroom. Okay, we're getting into number 5 and number 3, which go together. So my teacher bag. This is going to be just a really quick overview of my teacher bag. I will be doing an updated teacher bag video that goes into very specifics of what's in there. But it's important for you to have a bag. I guess you don't have to, but I just like it because it's easier. I don't know. But my teacher bag is just this backpack from Kate Spade. Jennifer and I got these when we went on our IKEA trip. They were super duper on sale. So if you have a Kate Spade outlet near you, I think this was around $70 on sale. So it was a perfect buy. I like that it's waterproof. It's got that like waterproof material, and it's just perfect for carrying everything that I need. The second thing, so this is my third hack, and it's actually in the bag. So I'm not gonna go into depth because it's in the bag and I'm gonna do a video on that. But I do have a makeup essentials. I was gonna talk about makeup essentials. One thing I wanna mention is LipSense lipsticks, amazing for teaching. And then of course, Bare Minerals powder foundation. I love having that in here. And I am going to go into more detail of what's in this bag, like I said, in a separate video. So, oh, my phone just went off, sorry. the next part, which is also part of number 5, is to get a planner. Now, you can get any kind of planner that you want. I personally do not like having a lesson planner because I plan on planbook.com and I use the planner from Genuine Teaching, so Jennifer's planner from her TPT store. I really like using that one just for an overall plan, but I really like the Erin Condren Life Planner because there's enough space in here for me to plan my personal life and also put work-related things in here. So I'll just kind of show you what that looks like. So this week looks like this. And I'm not like a super big planner. Like I'm not gonna go through here and put a ton of stickers and like do all that. I just don't have time for that. But I do like to write down in different colors. I like to color coordinate. Everything in red is work-related. Everything in pink is me. So, and then I usually put a to-do list down here at the bottom with sticky notes, because I don't like to crowd everything, and then I can still flip up if there's other things written underneath. So I really like the Life Planner because it does allow me to do everything that I would need to do in a lesson planner. I just don't write my lessons in it. So I do have some post-it notes here for math topics that my teammate and I put together because I didn't want to write them down yet until they were final. So anyway, I love this planner. I also have a $10 off your first Erin Condren purchase down in the description box below. So if you're interested in getting an Erin Condren planner or anything from there, click that link and it will give you $10 off your first purchase. So number six is to organize your materials. Oh, my phone's going off again. I apologize. As you guys know, over the summer, I took all of my teaching resources and put them into binders, and I'm going to show you that right now. Number seven is to get into a routine 2 weeks prior to school. So what that means is 2 weeks prior to school starting, I start getting up early, I start prepping my meals for the day, I start making a plan, and I go to bed early and try to do all the things that I would do in the school year within my day at home. So that way it acclimates my body to what it's gonna go through when the school year starts again, and it's just an easier transition. Number eight, really, really important. Over the summer, I did a lot of this and I'm really glad that I did. Number eight is get organized and clean your house. I don't know about you guys, but during the school year, my house will start to fall apart. It gets dirty, it gets cluttered, and I just don't usually have the energy to clean it, deep clean it all the time. So I organized everything in my house over the summer. I got into a really good cleaning routine so that when the school starts up again, I will be in that routine and it'll be much easier for me to keep up with if I start now. Number nine is plan your year at a glance. What I do with this is I get all of my standards that I am working with. I don't need to worry about math because I have Eureka, but for reading, writing, social studies, and science, I pull all my standards together and I decide when I'm going to teach those standards and topics, and I write them in my planner. And like I said, I use Genuine Teaching's planner on her TPT store, so she has a really good setup for this. Separated by quarters, semesters, months, and it's really easy to plan a year at a glance. So I definitely recommend you plan for a year at a glance. It will help you when you're planning your specific lessons. Number 10, I said, have a last fling. Now, this means go out and have a fun weekend, go out and have a fun night, whether it's with your significant other or with your teacher friends or with your other friends or with your family. You need to have one last fling before the school year starts. That way you can say that you spent that time, that you were mentally ready to start the school year, but that you enjoyed your last moments. And I definitely think that that's really important to do. So those are my 10 back to school hacks. I hope they were helpful. Like I said, I will be doing an updated What's in My Teacher Bag video probably right after filming this video. So I hope you guys stay tuned for that. So if I'm in the same outfit for like four videos, please don't mind me. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful school year. And if you guys have any teaching hacks for back to school, please comment them down below or make a video and link it in a comment as well. Thank you guys so, so much. Have a magical day. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching till the end of this video and for being here to support my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel as well. Click the little bell next to the subscribe button. It will alert you when I post a new video and will help my channel grow. Thank you so, so much for watching, and have a magical day.